Hello students, welcome to my channel. In this channel we provide the in-depth knowledge of different programming languages like C, C++, Java, Python, etc. which differentiate you with others. In our series of simple pointers, today we are going to discuss another question. This series is going very well. I receive lot of mails, WhatsApp and phone calls. That sir, we are enjoying this series very much and we are gaining lot of knowledge regarding pointers. So please don't stop this series. So I tried to put my best level to this series. So let's discuss another question in this series, simple pointers. So try to concentrate. This is very important and very interesting question. Void mint int arr 3, 3 and 3. So here we are declaring a three dimension array or a multi dimension array, 3 rows and 3 columns and 3 arrays. So 3 by 3 ke 3 arrays becomes 3 dimension array. 3 dimension array is a combination of 2 dimension array, and 2 dimension array is a combination of 1 dimension array, and 1 dimension array is a combination of an integer. Now suppose we are try to access printf %u 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 arr comma arr 1 arr plus 1 comma arr plus 2. Sorry, what is arr here? Arr is a name of the array. Name of the array gives the base address of the 0th element of the array. As we have already discussed in the previous class, name of the array gives the base address of the 0th element of the array. In 3-dimension array, 0th element is 2-dimension array. Now, if we talk about 1-dimension array, rule will be exactly same. What? Ki all the elements will be stored in a continuous memory location. Physically, if you will say, so all the 3 into 3 into 3 means 27 elements will be stored in a continuous memory location, but logically it is divided into rows and columns, because arrays ki ek property kya hai, all the elements will be stored in a continuous memory location. That cannot be changed for 2 dimension, or it cannot be changed for 3 dimension or 4 dimension. Rules which is applicable for 1 dimension array, it is applicable to every dimension array. Why? Because it is an array. Getting my point? So name of the array is a pointer pointing to the 0th element of the array. In 1-dimension array, 0th element is an integer. So name of the array is a pointer to an integer. Now if we talk about 2-dimension array, in 2-dimension array, the 0th element is what? 0th element is 1-dimension array. So as in the case of 1-dimension array, name of the array is a pointer to an integer. But if we talk about 2-dimension array, name of the array is a pointer to a 1-dimension array, because 2-dimension array is nothing but a combination of 1-dimension array. So in 2-dimension, name of the array is not a pointer to an integer as in the case of 1-dimension array. Here name of the array is a pointer pointing to a 1-dimension array. And how many columns, it depends what is the size of the matrix. Now here if we talk about 3-dimension array, 3-dimension array is nothing but a combination of 2-dimension array. Bahut sare 2-dimension array ko mila ke ek 3-dimension bana diya gaya. And the rules will be exactly same. All the elements will be stored in a continuous memory location. And second, name of the array is a pointer pointing to the 0th element of the array. Or you can say name of the array gives the base address of the 0th element of the array. In 3-dimension array, 0th element is 2-dimension array. So here name of the array is not a pointer to an integer. Name of the array is not a pointer to a 1-dimension array. Here name of the array is a pointer pointing to a 2-dimension array. Getting my point? Now let's try to print %u 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 arr comma arr plus 1 comma arr plus 2. Arr is what? It's a name of the array. Now let's assume that base address is starting from 2686676. It can be any number. Just for the ease of understanding, we are assuming 2686676 is the base address of 0th element of this array. तो नेम ऑफ द एरे गिव्स द बेस एड्रेस ऑफ द जीरोथ एलिमेंट ऑफ द एरे दैट वी आर गेटिंग 268-6676. द आउटपुट फर्स्ट वी आर गेटिंग इज 268-6676. नाउ व्हेन आई राइट प्रिंट एफ परसेंटेज यू ARR प्लस वन, ARR इज व्हाट? ARR इज द नेम ऑफ द एरे. नेम ऑफ द एरे गिव्स द बेस एड्रेस ऑफ द जीरोथ एलिमेंट ऑफ द एरे, और यू कैन से नेम ऑफ द एरे इज ए पॉइंटर पॉइंटिंग टू द जीरोथ एलिमेंट ऑफ द एरे. तो दिस ARR इज होल्डिंग व्हाट? This ARR is holding the base address of a two-dimension array, which is starting from 1 and terminates with 9. 3 by 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now, increment depend upon what? Increment always depend upon the type of the pointer that we have already discussed in the previous class. Whenever a pointer is incremented, it always points to the next location of its type. This type ka address rahega. उतने बाइट्स वो इंक्रीमेंट करेगा. बेसिकली व्हाट हैपेंस इफ यू टॉक अबाउट इंटीजर, तो इंटीजर नो डाउट इंटीजर पॉइंटर होल्ड्स द बेस एड्रेस, बट एक्चुअली इट इज पॉइंटिंग टू हाउ मेनी बाइट्स? इट इज पॉइंटिंग टू 4 बाइट्स ना. तो वेन एवर इंटीजर पॉइंटर इज इंक्रीमेंटेड इट स्टार्ट पॉइंटिंग टू द नेक्स्ट लोकेशन ऑफ इट्स टाइप. तो वेन एवर वी एड 1 टू अ इंटीजर पॉइंटर इट विल इंक्रीमेंट 4 बाइट्स. When we add 1 to the character pointer, it will increment 1 byte. When we add 1 to the double pointer, it will increment 8 bytes. Same thing, when we add 1 to the ARR, it will increment how many bytes? It will increment 36 bytes or 36 bytes. Why? Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 elements, 9 into 4, 36. So next what we are getting 268-6712. So 676 plus 36 is become 712. It will start pointing to the first element of this 3-dimension array, which is 123, 123 and 123, as in the case of here. So we will get 712. Then ARR plus 2, it will increment 36 plus 36, that is 72. So 676 676 plus 36 plus 36, it becomes 748. So now that pointer start pointing to the second element of this 3-dimension array, which is again a 2-dimension array, because every element is what? 2-dimension. Zeroth element, first element, second element, that is 2-dimension array. Now if we talk about printf percentage u percentage u percentage u arr 0 comma arr 0 plus 1 comma arr 1. Now arr 0 gives what? The base address of this array. Okay, now do you agree with this point? Just hold on, I will start this pen. Now do you agree with this point? The base address of 1 and the base address of this 1-dimension array and the base address of this 2-dimension array and the base address of 3-dimension array all will be 268-6676, because the first element of all these arrays are starting from 268-6676. Means if I talk about what is the base address of 1, you will say 268-6676. If I talk about the first 1-dimension array, that is 1, 2, 3, you will say 268-6676. One first 2-dimension array 268-6676 and this 3D array 268-6676. Getting my point? So when I write ARR 0, when I write ARR, I am getting the base address of 2-dimension array, but when I write ARR 0, I am getting the base address of this 1-dimension array. That is why we are getting 268-6676. Now when I write ARR 0 plus 1, AR 0 plus 1, now ARR 0 gives the base address of this 1-dimension array. When we add 1, it will start pointing to the next 1-dimension array, that is 456, and the address of 456 is 268-6688. From 76 plus 12, it is 268-6688. Now when I write ARR 1, ARR 1 what? ARR 1 gives the base address of this array, this 2D array. That is why we are getting 268-6712. ARR 0 gives the base address of this, ARR 0 plus 1 gives the base address of this, and ARR 1 gives the base address of this, 1, 2, 3. Getting my point? Now when I write arr 1 1, arr 1 gives 2 6 8 6 7 1 2 plus 1 2 3, 3 into 4 12, that is 7 1 2 plus 12, that is 7 2 4. So I am getting the base address of this. Here I am getting the base address of this, and here I am getting the base address of this. Here I am getting the base address of this. And now when I write arr 1 0 plus 1, so arr 1 this. Getting my point? Arr 1 this. Sorry, arr 1 I am getting this. 712. Arr 1 means 712. Plus 0, 712. Plus 1, it will increment to 716. So I am getting 716. This means base address of 2. And last 2 6 8 6 6 8 8, when I write arr 0 plus 1, arr 0 is what? 2 6 6 2 6 8 6 6 7 6 plus 1, it will increment how many bytes? It will increment 12 bytes. So you are getting 2 6 8 6 6 8 8. So this is how the things are working. Go through this. Any doubt you can ask me. This is very 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 important, believe me. So I think we should stop here. If you like the content of this channel, please like, share and subscribe as much you can. It will motivate us. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.